I never have to use it, but something tells me I will. Never trust a tourist advertisement. Never trust a tourist advertisement.
Now get out!
At last, Mr. Charles Reed. What a pleasure to finally meet you in the flesh.
Nice to meet you,
Johannes Vandenberg, at your service. I did promise to meet you the moment you arrived.
Ah, much obliged, Mr. Vandenberg. I guess I didn't expect you to mean so literally.
Please call me Johannes. But where are my manners? Welcome to the proud city of Oakmont. Alas, now is not its finest hour, though it is its most important.
You said you know someone who can help me with my problem. The visions have been getting worse.
Such vividness of dreams is not uncommon here in Oakmont. By chance, the man I spoke of, Robert Throgmorton, is already at the port. He has dedicated a lot of time and effort to investigate this issue. Alas, I fear he has a more pressing matter on his hands.
How can I find Mr. Throgmorton?
Don't worry, you can't miss him. Throgmorton tends to stand out from the crowd.
I'll need a place to lay my head while I'm here. Any recommendations?
Fear not. I've already feathered a nest for you. There's a room in your name at the Devil's Reef Hotel. Here's the key.
Sounds charming.
Don't judge a book by its cover, Mr. Reed.
What's the best way to get around Oakmont? I'd like to drop my things at the hotel.
Most locals go by foot, or by boat. I've got the latter sorted for you. There's one waiting outside the port.
You're too kind, Johannes. Can you steer me towards the Devil's Reef?
Take this map. I've marked the hotel and a few other key places.
Other places? Like what?
You're a private eye, yes? Well, I've highlighted the police station, city archive, newspaper. Places you'll need to get to. This city is insular, its ways mysterious. No one will take you by the hand, so you better know where to turn in search of a lead.
Well, that's it for now, I think. Thanks for helping me get my bearings.
No. The pleasure was mine, Mr. Reed.
Oh, before you go, how can I get in touch with you later?
Don't worry about that. I'm the kind of man who finds you.
I don't care about your petty excuses. No one leaves the port until my son is found, and that is final.
Excuse me. Are you Robert Throgmorton?
I am, but not interested. Go away.
The name's Charles Reed. I'm a private investigator, just arrived from Boston. I was told you might be able to help me.
Private investigator, you say? Well, perhaps we can help each other.
If I may ask, what happened to your son?
Why do you care? What's your angle, outsider?
Well, like I said, I'm a PI. Finding people is kind of my specialty.
Is it? Well, Albert was part of a deep-sea expedition I commissioned. This useless fool over here says he found Albert washed ashore in a lifeboat. Says he was barely conscious, out of his mind, talking gibberish in some other language. That he even tried to bite him.
And you don't believe him?
Complete malarkey. I know my Albert. I raised him strong and smart, the best of his kind. It couldn't have been him. Albert's disappearance is the work of Innsmouthers, mark my words.
I've heard you're the man to speak to about visions, outbreaks of hysteria. I'm trying to get to the bottom of it myself.
Another newcomer with another problem. Yes, I know what you speak of.
Can I ask you a few questions?
How dare you? My son Albert is missing, and no one in this Innsmouther-ridden city will do a damn thing. But yes, let's talk about your dreams.
I take it you're not the biggest fan of these Innsmouthers.
Those fish-faced freaks have overrun this city since the police burned Innsmouth to the ground. But now, those filthy migrants occupy half this damned city. The port, Grimhaven Bay, Salvation Harbor, the Shells. They are everywhere.
So they're just refugees?
Hardly. They've taken work from the local fishermen. They stir and agitate against us, the Throgmorton family. We are the pillar of this community, not to mention that crime rates have skyrocketed. Simply speaking, they are a big stinking pile of trouble.
Please forgive the question, but I've never met a man quite like you before.
That's because no man measures up to the Throgmorton lineage. Proud and powerful blood flows through our veins. My father united with a certain royal family, which has blessed all our offspring with these exquisite features.
Mr. Throgmorton, let me help you. I'm rather good at tracking down missing people. I'll find Albert.
What makes you think you can do it? Oakmont is not exactly friendly to new arrivals.
Let's just say I tend to see things that others miss. And anyway, what have you got to lose? Sounds like you could use every man you can get.
Vera, you have a point, newcomer.
Sorry, did you just say Vera? What does that mean?
You had better get used to the Oakmont dialect, outsider. That is, if you want to fit in. It is a fascinating blend. Vera means fine. I was saying, we have a deal.
I see. Thank you. I need to know more about what happened to Albert.
Dane, did you not listen at all? I already told you everything. After leaving on the expedition, Albert was found on the shore in a lifeboat. This fisherman supposedly brought him to their house, and then left to call me. But when I arrived here, my son was nowhere to be seen.
Anything else?
Clearly, something suspicious occurred inside the house. I suggest you stop dawdling and go see for yourself.
Where's the house where this all happened?
For Kay's sake, I thought you were a private eye. We're standing right in front of it.
You mentioned a lifeboat. Is it still around?
Yes. Face the house, then to the left is a beach that borders a fence. You'll find it there.
As much as I'm enjoying the weather, Mr. Throgmorton, it's time for me to get started.
Find my son, newcomer, and be quick about it.
The book is damp and damaged, but clearly well cared for. Huh. This dog mat looks better than the owner's bed. It would take tremendous effort to move this thing, let alone tossing it over like this.
Let's see what you find, newcomer.
Choo-choo. Ahem. Choo-choo. Ahem. Choo-choo. Ahem. Choo-choo. Ahem. Seen knives like this before. Masterful work. Seems like Prohibition hasn't affected Oakmont too much. So that's what an Innsmouther looks like.
Grinna, Nihri, Grinna, Gibhal, Nugulain, Hafton. Grinna, Nihri, Grinna, Gibhal, Nugulain, Hafton.
Seen knives like this before. Masterful work. Seems like Prohibition hasn't affected Oakmont too much. I'm surprised they don't have someone's portrait here. Five cards short of a full house. I can barely recognize the face of the poor fella. He was beaten to a pulp. Hey, can you hear me?
Oh, my head. What? Who are you? Are you police? I've already told them everything.
It's okay. I'm Charles Reed, Private Eye. Mr. Throgmorton hired me to find his son.
Okay. What do you want?
I want to know what happened here. Every detail.
I don't remember much. Me, Paul, and Lewis. We were here. This is our house. Barry was outside, on his business. Then he came back carrying Throgmorton's son. He was unconscious, barely breathing. Barry left again to call Mr. Robert.
Then what?
We put the guy in Lewis's room. Then he started to make these horrible sounds and... okay. My head began to burst, and he woke up, and after that, I don't remember a thing, just dreams. Drowned streets, a sleeping giant, a voice that called me,
That sounds familiar. Tell me about yourself.
Name's Will. Will Hammond. I'm a fisherman. We all are. Live here together. Me, poor fella Paul, Barry, and Innsmouther Lewis Flynn. We moved here after the flood. I worked on the railroad, but the rail ain't kicking anymore, so I started fishing. It was out of starve.
Where are all the other guys?
That's Paul there on the floor. Kay be with him. Barry's outside with Mr. Throgmorton. Lucky rascal missed everything. And I have no idea where Lewis or Throgmorton's son got to. Starting to suspect the worst.
Do you know how Paul died?
I don't know. When I pulled myself together, he was already gone. Kay, have mercy on his soul.
Who is this Kay you keep mentioning?
Outsider, show some respect. Kay is our lord, our light, our love.
Sorry, I didn't know. I'll leave you to it. Take care of yourself, Will.
Please, Detective, sir, tell me the truth. Could it be me? Did I kill Paul? Or, Kay, did I kill him?
I don't know yet, Will. The police will stop anyone coming in or out of here, so I suggest you just try and get some rest.
I'm afraid of what I might dream. head. I still hear those voices. What's happening?
Take this, ape face.
What's happening? What?
Take this, ape face. Yeah, run!
When Albert Throgmorton woke up, he was not himself. He attacked the fishermen and his hysteria spread to them. When he got wounded, he fled.
head. I still hear those voices.
Let's see what you find, newcomer.
I can barely recognize the face of the poor fella. He was beaten to a pulp.
I've said everything I know.
Don't do anything stupid, newcomer. And keep your hands where I can see them.
take tremendous effort to move this thing, let alone tossing it over like this.
My head! I still hear those voices.
So the fisherman pursued Albert, even let off a few shots. Even though Albert was wounded, he managed to climb that high. Robert wasn't exaggerating when he said he raised him strong. Blood is fresh. Whomever it belongs to could not have got far.
fudge. Fatal round through the forehead. That's no accident. This was deliberate. Fatal round through the forehead. That's no accident. This was deliberate.
The port is closed by order of Robert Throgmorton. Back off.
Stay alert. Monsters lurk underground. They're everywhere.
Welcome to Under the Keel. What do you want?
I'm looking for a man by the name of Lewis Flynn. Any chance he's here?
Yeah. Even if I knew, I don't rat to newcomers.
As it happens, I know you owe a debt to Mr. Flynn. Trouble is, I found your note near the dead body of Albert Throgmorton, son of Robert. So, it seems Lewis is in trouble. Might have even come here to hide. But you hand him over, and he won't be back to collect what you owe. Get me?
Throck. That would explain the blood. Fine. If it gets me out of this mess, you can have him.
So?
He's upstairs. Here's the key. You gotta promise to deal with him once and for all. But save the shooting for outside, huh?
Smart man. There's your good deed for the day. Bye.